been, can they upset the United States tonight, the defending champions? Well, we shall see. Already today, France beating Nigeria, and Canada falling to China in classification games. So France will face China in the battle for fifth place tomorrow. And after this one, we'll have Spain against Australia in the other semifinal. I'm Jeff Taylor, joined by Shona Thorburn. I kid you not, the former Canada international. And we've had a great time here in Tenerife. And we're also at the business end of the tournament, Shona. So in many respects, Belgium can't lose because not many people expected them to be here.
No, they can't, but that's the great thing about this Belgium team. Now they've made history. They've accomplished something that I'm sure they could never have even imagined. But the beauty is, just keep playing the way they've been playing and who knows what will happen. I mean, they're now playing the U.S. in a semifinal of the 2018 FIBA Women's World Cup. Who would have thought that when Ann Waters was growing up and playing basketball in Belgium? So I'm just so happy for this team, and it's so well deserved, just the way that they have played and how they have executed, especially in these last two games. It's been beautiful, beautiful basketball.
And really, this is a tough test because the United States, you know, always has that element of continuity from previous runs. They've got Sue Bird in their lineup. They've also got Diana Taurasi in their lineup, Brittany Griner, Brandon Stewart, who's now been a part of this USA team, Elena Deladon, Agwumike as well, Nick Agwumike. So, you know, this is a team, and Tina Charles, this is a team that has brought in some newcomers, but it's also got some players that have been there before. They've been in these situations before. Dawn Staley, the assistant coach before, now the head coach. So they've been kind of cruising up to this point. They had some difficult moments in this tournament, but I don't think anybody ever felt like they were really in trouble.
No, and you know, you mentioned they do have a good mix of newcomers. Sorry, first time appearances for some of these players at this level with the senior team. But as you mentioned, you know, that word, the names, Taurasi, Bird, they've been around also. You know, you have Brianna Stewart, Elena Deladon, Brittany Griner. They're still incredibly experienced. And like you said, they have been cruising. I don't think they played the best basketball, to be honest. They've sort of let people maybe stay in it a little bit longer than we have seen in the past by some U.S. teams. That being said, there's two games left, and you know when it counts, the U.S. are ready to step up.
Okay, well, we are going to have a pause in the commentary for the playing of the national anthems of the United States and Belgium.
Number 42, Yana Raman. And number 55, Julie Alemán. The head coach is Philippe Mesta. Assistants are Pierre Cornia and Sven Van Kamp. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the national anthems of the two nations playing in this game. First, the national anthem of the United States of America.
Thank you.
Please remain standing for the national anthem of Belgium.
Always a great moment before these games to hear the national anthems. Just kind of sets the tone for a great game of international basketball. So the referees tonight, we'll get a look at them. Johan Rosso of France, Yu Jung from Chinese Taipei, and Daniel Garcia from Venezuela. There they are. Johan is in the middle and taking his customary position there in the middle as the crew chief. And from Venezuela on the right, and Daniel Garcia on the left. And it has to be said, the fact that they're doing this game recognizes they've been evaluated throughout the tournament, and they've been doing a good job. So here they are. So, USA.
You talked about them all right before, Jeff. Asia Wilson has stepped up. Brianna Stewart. Here's their starting five. Super, Brianna Stewart, Diana Taurasi, Tina Charles, and Brittany Griner. No surprise there. I mean, but this is the woman, Brianna Stewart. 17 points a game, 62% field goal, 5.8 rebounds, 2.8 assists. When they have had lulls in their offense especially, she has been the woman who has stepped up and scored for them, Jeff.
And for Belgium?
I mean, right away, Kim Mestag's a name that jumps out at me in this tournament. Emma Messman, Anne Waters. They've just had contributions from absolutely everyone. Kim Mestag, Antonia Dallaire, Emma Messman, Kira Linskins, Julie Almond. Talk about a performance the other night for Julie Almond. And here's Emma Messman, one of the best women's basketball players in the game right now. 16 points a game, 47% shooting, 12.3 rebounds. She's averaging a double-double so far in this tournament. But that woman right there, Julie Almond, against France last night, she had 13 assists. She ties the record in a World Cup for the number of assists. How about that at your first ever World Cup? You already come out.
Let's make it a statement.
In the record books.
We're going to go right to dive. Okay, right to dive. We're going to have BGU dive. Dive right to the middle of the zone. That probably means zone.
By 12-year-old Adriana. Please give her a warm welcome. Señoras y señores, en estos instantes el balón de juego Molten
presentado por el defensa. For example, with Kim in this situation, in the thumb down. Emma, as you downstream, come back and set your screen like that.
Well, it's been a memorable FIBA Women's Basketball World Cup, to put it mildly. A lot of highs, a lot of lows, some surprises, some late wins, some blowouts, but a lot of talking points. And I think really, you know, this Belgium team has really kind of captured the imagination of basketball fans here. And this is a big test. And I don't think there are that many people, honestly, that expect them to come out and beat the United States tonight. But underestimate this team, and you could get punished.
Exactly. I mean, I don't think France nor Spain underestimated this Belgium team, but they're just maybe playing that good. And like I said, we haven't seen the U.S. team that we're typically used to seeing, where they have dominated from the opening tip. They have actually almost let every team stay around for a while, like actually 20 minutes, a half. So maybe that's something that this Belgium team were thinking about.
Good evening, folks. Welcome to the Santiago Martin. We are in Tenerife, Spain, the Canary Islands, way down off the west coast of Africa. And this is the first semifinal. And the United States coming out strong, getting the first basket from Brittany Griner. This is what they call the business end of the tournament. This is when you can expect the USA to really start bringing their best. Lenskins. And misses with the jump shot. Brittany Griner turns and runs into a little bit of trouble. They're hemmed in by Mestag and Lenskins.
Good job by Mestag going over and doubling Brittany Griner and helping out her teammate Lenskins on the low post there.
Now, you know, they have been studying their tapes about how they were so effective, and already Alamon starts with a three-pointer. They've shot the ball well at times. They've had a lot of success with their pick and rolls, their give and goes. It's one thing to scout it and to know how you're supposed to stop it. It's something else to actually do it. Alamon drives in, maybe in a little bit of a rush there.
Although, do you ever think growing up, Alamon, I'm sure she watched Sue Bird like many people, that she knew she'd be going head-to-head with her at some point in her life. How cool is that?
Very cool. Here she is, and hitting the three-pointer as well. She's got big game veins, shall we say. Blood running in her veins. Big game blood. How about that? Well, Delar over to Mestag, who's been tough. There's Emma Messerman with a little runner. Little pump fake. No intimidation from Messerman. Look at that. And she knows them as a WNBA player.
Exactly. I was just going to say that. She is not intimidated. She's, you know, a WNBA star. She does her thing over there. She really knows them well.
Also faces them when she's competing in Europe, you know, with the big clubs. All these top flight Americans
Emma Messerman come plays over with a few of these women.
So here's Delar. Going at Tina Charles. And the Venezuelan referee called a foul. This was Messerman. You have to beat Charles, and then you have to shoot over Griner. No problem. Alemán. Mestag starts out strong. And just as they have done the last couple of games, Belgium coming out and firing. Bird to Griner. She goes up against Lenskins. Soft touch from Brittany Griner. Somebody had a handful of Mestag jersey there. Now, Bird crosses midcourt to Brianna Stewart, and she scores in transition and draws the foul.
And already right away in this first 3 minutes, this is a different U.S. team than we saw yesterday, Jeff.
It is. Oh, yeah, she got her right on the left wrist. Yep, they're coming out and running. There's Penny Taylor. I guess we can call her a legend now since she stopped playing for Australia. The MVP, the World Cup back in 2006. And jump shot is good from Messerman. Now, DT, good, the three-pointer. USA take the lead. Alamon to Lenskins. And Stewie knocks it over Alemán's head and into the hands of her teammate. Now, Tarazi had a rough quarterfinal, but she's come out and hit the three, and now another shot down low for Tina Charles. And good play from Brittany Griner, getting her hands up. And again, Stewie, as calm as you like, goes in and puts it up off the glass and in. It's been a bright start by Belgium, and they're trailing 14-9. That's how good this USA team is. Alemán. Over to Messemann, pump fake. Just goes right in for the layup. Interesting, we got veteran USA team out there now. Messemann, she's fouled by Charles. It's interesting how Charles is one of the four players on the court right now who played at the University of Connecticut under Gino Auriemma, who, by the way, the former USA coach Auriemma in the stands.
Morgan Tuck also played there. Elena Del Don spent a summer there. I just talked to you about how important that program is and the kind of players that Gino Auriemma is able to develop and the careers that they have.
Yep, sells itself, doesn't it? Van Loo!
We saw Kia Nurse of Canada who played there.
Aguimake gets the rebound, Stanford Cardinal. And the rejection from Ledskins.
So they're saying.
Yeah, they might have caught a break, Belgium.
Threw it out of bounds.
Alemán. Van Loo from the left. It's good. Raining three-pointers. We got a tie game. Tarazi drives right down the lane. Ball goes out of bounds over to Belgium. Rahman in the game for Belgium. Rahman, number 42, and Van Loo. Also, Hannah Mestag is in the game, giving her sister an early breather. Both Mestags can shoot it. Ledskins from the right. It's good. Oh, Belgium.
They have come out, and they're not intimidated, like we've seen for the past two games. They had that one tough loss to Japan.
Tarazi comes back.
In overtime during the group phase. But since then, have they ever turned the corner? And they're playing at a level that is podium worthy.
Van Loo with a pump fake. Alemán, not that time. Yep, they've beaten Spain here in Spain. And they've beaten France. But this is perhaps a more difficult task, the USA, but they're hanging with them right now. Hannah Mestag.
Yeah, they beat Spain, second-ranked, FIBA-ranked team in the world, sorry.
And Rahman tripped up.
Fourth. Maybe they're ready to take off the first. I'm just saying, they've already taken out the second, the fourth.
At the end of the day, it's basketball, isn't it? And you play. Ledskins goes out, Messemann comes back in. Tarazi, Griner go out. Asia Wilson now in the game, as is Jewel Lloyd for the United States.
Two people making their first appearance with the senior team here for the U.S.
And a Mestag gets into the lane. Some contacts. And the foul on Wilson. So Alemán comes out and Carprio comes in. You see Snoopert wearing the face mask. And she goes out of the game. And see Aguamuke there getting that. A little bit of arm. So Kelsey Plum also in the game for the USA. Messerman gets it to Van Loo. To Morain. Belgium playing like they are possessed right now. Well, in fact, they have been.
Wow.
The last three games.
They have been. They are on another level right now. And it's so exciting and fun to watch.
Aguamuke dribbles, takes her down to the size of Carprio, who knocks it away. Here's a player that likes the big stage. Mustag. Aguamuke this time gets inside and gets rejected by Messerman. Carprio crosses midcourt. Julie Van Loo has hit a couple of threes already. She gets it back to Messerman. Got it. Well,
and that's why this gym is almost sold out. They came to watch Belgium play, Jeff.
Well, the USA, you know they're good. And Belgium proving they're every bit as good so far. Plum from the right, rattles out. Long rebound to Lloyd. Stewart. Just calm as you like, goes in and scores that left hand.
And like I said, I think Stewart is so talented because she is 6'4", and she plays like a guard.
Carprio gets into the lane behind the back. Rahman loses it as she gets inside, and the ball goes out of bounds off of Asia Wilson. Here again is Aguamuke. Oh, there might have been some
maybe
some
not
arm.
By Messman, but I think it was Dillard who maybe fouled her first.
And then this was when the Messman hit that short jump shot. Mestag got a little space. And a foul called on the USA. So that, are they over the limit now? 104 remaining, so two shots. Rahman goes out. Lenskins comes back. It's Messerman at the line. Already off to a fast start. Messerman, you can see. Look at the Spain fans. They're excited about this one.
Well, maybe they're thinking if Belgium can upset the U.S., it might be. I'm imagining that the Spain fans here are all rooting for Spain to move on, play in the final. So maybe they're thinking, hey, we have a better chance of beating Belgium than the U.S.
That
in
might,
a potential gold medal game.
But they've already lost to them once.
They have.
Lenskins gets her hands up, prevents the pass to Asia Wilson. Van Loo on the break, pulls it out. Carprio goes behind her back, going at Lloyd. Messerman hands it off to Van Loo, puts it up. Now Lloyd pushes it for the USA. Aguamuke, and if you're gonna foul Carprio, you gotta foul so she doesn't make the shot. There's Oriema, the right corner of the screen.
I mean, she did foul pretty hard, I think. Aguamuke is just so much stronger that she was able to get that ball off and score it.
Aguamuke makes the free throw, the three-point play, gets it back to a two-point game. Lenskins, quick pass, Messerman, and a foul as well.
You saw
That's a good call. Asia Wilson just kind of slid right into Messaman.
No, I think it's a great call. Good pass by Linsken. She sort of looked like she was going to shoot it, saw Messaman underneath. You know, and then you saw the veteran, Kim Mestag, huddle her team up. And I think she told them, hey, guys, we have a foul to give. So no easy baskets. If you need to, take a foul, but not on the shot.
Kelsey Plum gets in, and after the final buzzer goes off, so, well, you know, there was a moment there where the USA looked like they might start pouring it on, but here again, you can see the board light up before Plum releases it. Belgium come back. And they have a 26-21 lead at the end of the first quarter here in the Santiago Martin, this first semifinal of the FIBA Women's Basketball World Cup.
Yeah, but yeah, these are details, and details will decide the game. Okay? Follow my lead.
Well, welcome back. Who would have thought after one it would be 26-21 in favor of Belgium? And that's why. They're shooting 64%. They've already forced the U.S. to turn the ball over seven times. They have six assists. They're sharing the ball. I mean, they have four or five people who have scored for them already. And that's how they have won the last two games. And they've just come into this game with absolutely no fear against the number one team in the world. They're also playing at a level that no one around the basketball community could have ever expected Belgium to be able to play at. And it's pure joy for this Belgium Cats team.
Well, the USA Deladon is now going to check into the game. This will be a first look. Diana Taurasi is back as well. Stewart remains in the contest, as well as Jewel Lloyd and Plum. I think far from being nervous, the USA also really relishing the challenge. They want a game, and so far Belgium are giving them one. Van Loo. Over to Messaman, Linskens. And Stewart with the rebound. Wide open, Jewel Lloyd. Good, soft touch from the left corner.
For number four, Jewel Lloyd of the United States. Triple number four.
This is back to a two-point game now. Linskens all the way over to Carpriou. Carpio turns it over. Now Plum has it to Stewart. And Stewart misses. Well, Belgium dodged a bullet there. Oh, shifty move from Van Loo off the back of the iron. Taurasi open. Good. Diana Taurasi already playing better than she did last night.
Yeah, she struggled a little bit yesterday. I just don't feel like she ever got into a rhythm.
Big game, Diana Taurasi. And Mestag gets in and scores. Lloyd to Taurasi. And to Deladon. And the ball bounced off the rim. Stewart was in there for the tap, but it bounced over ahead. Carpio over to Messaman. And Lloyd with the board. USA can go back in front with the basket. Charge called on Lloyd. Over the shoulder. It's a good call. Mestak did a good job of just finding a little bit of space there behind Taurasi. And nobody helped out. And she just scored over Plum. So Griner back, Stewart out. Alamon also back in, as well as Dillard. Dillard says, maybe I'll bring it back out to Alamon. Dillard, good! Three-pointer. Great patience. First three that she's taken, and she makes it. Bird to Griner. Goes to work on Messelman. Follows up her shot. Well, that's tough to stop right there. Mestak back to Messelman. Back to Rahman. Belgium passing it around. Rahman's going to go to Griner. And Rahman traveled. Griner needs to move her feet and keep her hands up. She's going to score over her.
No one can score over her. No, absolutely. You said it. And here. I mean, she can almost just pass the ball to herself if she doesn't have a good shot and go follow it. You really have to try and box her out, push her under, or push her out.
Now the dump to Griner. Alamon. And then Alamon dribbled it off her foot. Staley. One of the all-time great USA basketball players. Olympic gold medalist.
Olympic flag bearer.
Yep, Olympic flag bearer. And from the corner, that was Bird. Deladon chases. Dillard, guarded by Bird, into Messelman. Back up top to Rahman. Now Mestak puts it up, got a little daylight. Tried to bank it in, Plum comes back now. Bird over to Deladon, who gets into the lane. And what a soft touch from Elena Deladon. And Philip Mestak calls timeout.
And here you see offensive rebounds.
USA.
The U.S. only had two. I would be pretty happy with myself after 15 minutes of play that I've only given up two offensive rebounds to an incredibly athletic and tall USA team.
You know, USA played Nigeria in their quarterfinal. And, but Belgium are a different proposition altogether. Just the way they've been playing.
Yeah,
and
no,
as the game gets shorter, you know, Belgium must be thinking, well, you know, we played 15 minutes, 14 minutes, and it's 31-31. You know, we got a better chance. Maybe we've got a better chance than a lot of people have been giving us, have been telling us about. Look at Dina Taurasi, though, tonight. She's on fire. 8 points already, averaging 8.5 in the tournament. Dillard goes to her right. So what will Belgium do coming out of the timeout? Alamon. Dillard puts up a long one, and Rahman is able to hustle Pete Bird to the ball. And now she gets it inside.
Super might have got away with a little foul on the shot there.
And it's Rozzi, a little careless with the ball. Now quickly to Aleman. And she gets it up and in right before Stewart was able to get there. Stewart from deep. And Delar in Belgium. Aleman with a little reverse. Well, she was in position. She just didn't make it. Now Bird in the USA. Hannah Mestag trying to get the hands up. Now Rahman. Well, that's a tough assignment for anybody. Della Don just puts it in and ties it. Linskins for three, and ball bounces out of bounds. So that three-point shooting for Belgium is dropping a lot. It's now below 30%. Down to 29%, 4 of 14.
And they have taken only 15 two-point attempts. So I imagine, I mean, they were hitting them early, but maybe it is a little intimidation factor. They see the you know, a Brittany Griner underneath, Brianna Stewart coming from help side.
Well, Bird's three misses. And great hustle from Stewart, but I think she, well, this thing, she's already out of bounds. Yep. It's that extra effort, though, that makes a difference in these games.
Oh, it might have hit her after it bounced off Hannah Mestag's leg.
Quick pass to Messerman. She's surrounded by Tarazi. Well, she was being harassed, was Messerman. She tried to get it to Delar, and Delar couldn't control it. So Van Loo comes back in. Delar goes out. What do you think about the tempo of the game right now?
You know, I don't. I think the U.S. could actually play a little faster and use their athleticism and their bench a little bit more, maybe try and tire out this Belgium team.
Della Don, good, the three-pointer.
I think right now the pace actually favors Belgium.
Well, quite a nice player to bring off the bench at the start of the second quarter. Della Don.
And we saw her hurt her foot yesterday. We
believe nice shifty move, Carpio. And she beat everybody, but then Griner finally reacted and got over and got the swat. Now the pass to Stewart out of bounds. The pass from Tarazi.
That's pretty intimidating. You're going up for a layup, and then Brittany Griner comes out of nowhere. I mean, just the length. She's so tall.
Yeah, I'm not sure Carpio will do that again. Carpio travels. 2 minutes and 13 seconds remaining in the first half, and Belgium are right there where they'd like to be, but the USA can put points on the board quickly.
And they can. Start hitting, Belgium's in a zone. If they start hitting some outside shots,
the score could go up quickly. Here's Della Don. Oh, she gets it inside, and well, you wouldn't think she would miss that the way she's been playing so far. She does. Linskins hands it off to Van Loo, who slipped. And a Mestag. Good! Another three-pointer. Boy, how proud must Philip Mestag be? He's got a couple of girls that know how to play the game. Linskin's called for the foul. Griner. She was set. She was ready to go right when she caught it.
She was, and clearly, Philip Mestak, the coach of Belgium, did a good job of developing his daughter's shots because both of them are incredible three-point shooters.
Tarazi for three, and Stewart comes in. Linskins blocks her, and great hustle from Carprio. Belgium's fans are giving it the support, the love to their team as they are refusing to give in here against the USA. Linskins hands it off. Now Julie Van Loo. Seven on the shot clock. And Tarazi almost comes up with a steal. Five on the shot clock. What play are they going to run? Well, we know they don't need much time to get baskets after beating Spain with just 1 second. Well, she fakes the handoff. Carpio puts up the jumper this time. And Deladome with the rebound. Good defense from Linskins. Again, good defense, but Griner. Just great passing from the USA bigs. Back and forth to each other.
Yeah, really. And this is a team that actually haven't spent a lot of time together. So for them to already have kind of the feeling of where your teammates are going to be. I mean, Brianna Stewart got up in the air, did a 160 to try and pass it out to Griner, knowing that she was going to be there.
Look at the USA faithful there. Seven points for Griner. So, 38-36 here in the final minute. Carprio over to the Linskins. She's shown that she can hit the jumper. She's raising eyebrows tonight, folks.
And what I like that is that Linskins can bring out Brittany Griner, which then will open up things on the inside for this Belgium team.
Look at this. She is, you know, last year, bit part player on the Belgium team that finished third at the FIBA Eurobasket Women. This year, major minutes in a FIBA Women's Basketball World Cup semifinal. That's quite a progression. So, and Dina Taurasi taking exception to Van Loo. They're just competitive.
Yeah, they are. I mean, Belgium knew that they had a foul to give. I don't mind this. I mean, Diana Taurasi kind of got away with a little bit of a hold there.
Do you think part of that is Taurasi trying to get Van Loo out of her game?
Possibly.
In Belgium?
I mean, if you've watched any of Diana Taurasi's WNBA games recently, not just recently, Diana likes to talk. She'll, you know, give you a little chatter during the game, and I think part of that is just her competitiveness, but maybe also, like you said, the psychological factor, her trying to get people guarding her, who she's guarding, off their game.
She makes the first. She wants to rip your heart out on the court. But after, she's like the nicest person ever.
Absolutely the nicest person ever.
She makes both. So Taurasi gives USA the lead, the timeout.
5.8 seconds. They will have one shot opportunity. They do have to go the full length of the court. Be interesting to see what kind of defense Coach Dawn Staley of the U.S. is going to ask the women to play.
Right. On the other side, I have Antonia, Kim, right? And I miss somebody.
So USA with 11 fast break points, two for Belgium.
So this will be completely open in 5 seconds, right? We open up everything. You attack. Okay? They will make a foul for sure, all right? Okay? This is possible. After, normally it will be on the side. You go quick, you go in our one half. This will be on the side. Okay, we take our one. Come on, here we go.
Wow. So he's drawing up a play here where he says they're going to foul for sure. This will be open.
he says
with such confidence.
But look at the foul count. The U.S. only have one foul. They don't want to give up anything easy, and you can kind of take time off the clock if you just continually foul. It can't be intentional.
Yeah.
And you don't want them to foul when they're going to shoot.
Oh, unsportsmanlike has been called. That's always a danger.
Unsportsmanlike foul called on number five.
She tried to go for the ball, but Mestag was, or Alemán was so far ahead that she couldn't get to the ball.
Yeah, so the unsportsmanlike foul, you have to be going for the ball, and I think the referees there thought that she did kind of wrap her arms around her, and she wasn't going for the ball. That, like you said,
here
we get a better angle.
She's trying. Oh, yeah. No, that's an unsportsmanlike.
Yeah.
There's no question.
I mean it's an easy call.
As it's been interpreted in international competitions the last couple of years. So she makes just one of two, get it back to a one-point game.
Substitution.
Well, we've seen Belgium score 2 points with 1.1 second left.
Exactly, against Spain. And now they've got 3.5 seconds. Here's Alemán again, and another foul called on Plum, which is not surprising.
You know, just watching this tournament, I think Julie Alemán is a lot faster.
Yeah.
Then
any
she looks
realize.
And that people realize.
Well, you can see Mestag asking the French referee if someone was tugging on her shirt. In any event, the USA lead it 40-39 in a fantastic first semifinal at the FIBA Women's Basketball World Cup.
Here we have the halftime stats. The reason Belgium's only 1 point behind is because they're shooting 56%. They're sharing the ball. Each team has 11 assists. They forced U.S. into 8 turnovers. Belgium do have 7 themselves. I mean, it's no surprise that they're only down 1 when they're playing this well. You're shooting 45% from the field compared to the U.S.'s 47. They actually have one more shot attempt than the U.S. Really, it makes sense why it's so close. And if I'm Belgium, I have to be happy with the way that this game's gone. And you talked about pace a little earlier, Jeff. I think it was after the first quarter. You said, who is it benefiting? And I said, right now, I feel like it's benefiting Belgium. They're kind of playing their style. They're playing at their pace, where I think the U.S., and given their athleticism and how fast they are, and how they do have 12 all-stars on their bench, I feel like they could play a little faster, maybe a little bit more athletic, and, you know, rotate people a little quicker and say, we need to get up and we just need to pressure and tire out this Belgium team because we've let them hang around with us for a little bit too long. That being said, I mean,
Can Belgium they break that pressure?
Yes.
You think Belgium can cope with that pressure?
I think they can cope with it, but I think it will tire them out.
Right.
And that's when the U.S. might start to pull away.
Do you think Belgium have expended more energy in the first half tonight than they did last night? And also, it seems to me that Mestag has gone to his bench earlier tonight to try to keep his players fresher.
Yeah, I agree with you. I think he's gone to his bench earlier. I mean, we can see that he's gone to his bench earlier. As far as do I think, I actually actually think they spent more energy yesterday.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Yeah.
Because they looked,
right now,
they were dragging.
Yeah, right now they look fresh. They look energized. They look excited.
Yeah.
So I think they're okay with the way the game's being played. I think they're playing the style that they want to play.
And I think what's great, there's interesting things on both sides. I mean, obviously it's great for the USA that Taurasi seems to have brought her A game, or at least her B plus game.
Yeah.
And that Della Donne continues just to show that she's immense, and Griner is just an amazing talent. Like the USA is able to rely on three or four players, so are Belgium. It's not just Messemann and Mestag, it's the Mestags. It's also Linskens tonight has been terrific. And Alemán has been great. Van Loo has had moments. You know, it's not a one-man game, yep. A one-woman game, rather. It's
And that's how they beat Spain, the number two ranked team in the world, and France, the number four ranked team in the world. Everyone who came on for Belgium contributed, and that's exactly what we're seeing here. They're not stepping, they're not worried, they're not intimidated, they're just going out and playing their style, and they're hitting shots like they've hit all tournament. They're just doing it against the number one team in the world right now.
Well, we're at halftime, folks. I know that you don't want to go anywhere, but nip to the kitchen to get a drink and then come on back. It's the United States leading it 40-39 over Belgium at halftime. We'll be right back.
TLC6 Watcher TV, una imagen excepcional, merece un sonido excepcional.
Well, 40-39, the USA on top of Belgium here at halftime in the first semifinal of the FIBA Women's Basketball World Cup. It is, in many respects, a David and Goliath type of meeting. USA, the true giants, of course, Belgium before last year's success at the FIBA Eurobasket Women. I mean, they had to qualify for the Eurobasket. They weren't even really considered to be among the elite teams in Europe, but their rise has been fast, and now they're taking on the likes of Tarazi, as you just saw there, who has 8 points in the first half. And Belgium seemingly able to cope with the pressure of the moment, the pressure that comes with facing a star-studded team. But you know what? They have stars of their own, and none of them are bigger than this woman right here, Emma Messemann, who really for the past decade has been growing in stature, and now she is among the best players in the world. Shona, it's what happens when you think in terms of Emma Messemann and Belgium? Are they going to suddenly wake up and be like, wow, we're playing the USA? We're not supposed to be this close. Or is this just a basketball game?
You know what? Right now, it's just a basketball game. And I think this Belgium team are just having fun. They are relishing the moment, what they have done so far. They're smiling. They just enjoy playing with each other. And what we haven't even talked about this, Jeff, but guess who hasn't played for them?
Ann Waters. Yeah, secret weapon coming off the bench.
And, you know, I imagine maybe they might be resting her for tomorrow.
I honestly thought that maybe Belgium would come out a little less enthusiastic, thinking that, well, our best chance is getting a medal tomorrow. But that has not been the case.
No, I mean, I think any, you know, I mean, I think even Mestak said that himself yesterday, and everybody interpreted also, you might not come out and give your best shot tonight, but you're in the semifinals of the FIBA Women's Basketball World Cup. It doesn't matter who you're playing. You're going to die on the hardwood. And if the game is close and maybe he needs Waters, he'll put her in. I don't have any doubt about that. But it's all about matchups. And look at Sue Bird. They've got that look, that same look that they've had before. Like, okay, we're going to shift gears into a higher gear. And let's see what they can do with that. But as we've seen, Alamon and Messemann and Mestag, Delar, Lenskin, so far, they've coped. They put their basketball shoes on the same way that we do. You know, the last time the USA women lost in this competition, back in the semifinals of the World Cup that was staged 12 years ago in Brazil. They lost that game to Russia. That was an upset. Tarazi, who's inbounding it here, was a part of that USA team, and she certainly doesn't want to experience that again. So USA on top by one, and we're about ready to get things going.
Well, folks, if you're back from your break at halftime, third quarter now underway, and the USA trying to go down low to Brittany Griner here on their first possession. And why wouldn't they? They had some success with her early tonight. So now the ball inbounded to Charles. Americans up by one. And Taurasi comes right out and buries the three-pointer.
And you can just see the focus and determination on Taurasi's face. She is not going to let this game slip away from her.
What about Mestag? Comes right out and answers wide open. Surely the Americans respect her ability to knock in a three-pointer. Taurasi again. Good. Uh-oh. She's having one of those games. She's just gone from B-plus to A. 16 points, 4 of 6 from deep. Taurasi. And the USA up by 4. Lenskins on the baseline.
And you know, Taurasi was quoted coming into this tournament. She remembers what it felt like in 2006 to lose. They haven't lost since then, keep in mind. But she said, I remember losing, and I'm going to do everything in my power to not feel that way again.
DeLore called for a foul. Thinking she had a steal. This is Lenskins. And Bird running out, getting the hand in the face. Lenskins has been tough tonight. And Messelman with the rebound. Now DeLore. And Alemán over to Mestag. Born to shoot. I mean, she is electric. 9 points for Mestag. DeLore called for the foul. Trying to stick with Taurasi, who's red hot right now. Alemán already has 8 assists tonight. Wow.
She might be going for another record.
Taurasi for 3. Good, another one. She lives for moments like this, folks. 19 points. And we're just 2 minutes into the second half. Mestag. And Charles grabs the rebound. And Lenskins just takes it right away from Griner. Denies her the pass. Oh, spin move! And Messelman goes in and a foul called. And again, you know, you get back to Messelman. She knows. She knows what this is about. She faces it annually.
She knows
in the
exactly.
WNBA.
Yeah, she knows what to expect. She knows what kind of defense. She knows how athletic, how quick they are, how long they are. Really, I think that's why we're seeing, I mean, we've seen a great game from her every game in this tournament, but you can just tell she's very familiar. She knows these people very well, and that's why I think she's as confident as she is.
The fans and family members with the Belgian flags painted on their face, the Belgian colors. Calls for hope here against the USA. Bird for 3. Charles with the rebound. Now Taurasi, Bird, if she gets another one, she might knock it in. Stewart for 3. Good! And Brittany Griner almost forcing the turnover. Alemán to DeLore. Mestag, she's got to launch it. And Charles with the rebound. Now they've got numbers. Bird decides to get it to Stewart. took the three instead of going to the basket. Alemán, Messelman, long jump shot, good. Back to a two-point game.
And Jeff, that's her ninth assist. She might be in double-digit assists two games in a row, Julie Alemán for Belgium.
Wow, she's fantastic.
And look at Messelman. Messelman's 6 for 6 from two.
Lars coming in, as well as Rahman, and Lenskens goes out. Sorry, Delar goes out. Van Loo and Rahman comes in. And when you lose Lenskens, you lose that great jump shot, but you've just added a jump shot with Van Loo. Jewel Lloyd in the game, number 4 for the USA. Belgium can tie it or go in front with a 3. Alemán. Oh, couldn't quite get the pass to Messelman, who was open. And Charles, Brittany Griner goes down, and the battle for the ball, and Rahman hustles down and is fouled. The USA had numbers. Quick pass to Messelman, puts it up and in over Charles, and we've got a tie game. Now Griner turns and scores. Boy, this is about as close as it gets, folks. Van Loo gets it to Mestag at the line. And good rebound, Charles. Outlet to Lloyd. Tarazi. Fouled by Rahman. Play the cream rises to the top in the big games.
They really do.
And Dinah Tarazi is very creamy. Because she's been amazing in this game. And Griner as well has been tough, but so have several of these Belgian players. And again, it's such an interesting situation with the USA now. They can bring in Deladon. He's got so many stars, world stars.
They do, and there's a nice article about Deladon saying she would leave the door open for the chance to possibly come and play in Europe. And how would some of those professional teams in Europe would love to have Deladon on their team?
Van Loo, back to Rahman. Rahman called for the foul of Griner.
A little bit of flaring, flailing from both of them there.
First one is good. And the second from Griner. USA up by 6. Is that their biggest lead of the game? And Waters checks in for Messelman, who's been terrific. Alemán takes the handoff. Now Rahman. Ah, tough pass to catch, but Alemán was able to save it and throw it off of Lloyd with 3.6 seconds remaining. Somebody's got to launch it. It's going to be Alemand. And Deledon brings it. Is this the moment where the USA start to pull away? They're up six. Deledon. Well, she took some contact. Van Loo. Passes it back out to Alemand. Long rebound to Alemand. And Tarazi goes over and extends the hand of friendship.
I mean, right here, Tarazi just couldn't stop herself.
Vestag. And Waters gets it, but a reach and a foul called on Rahman. So Rahman has to come out of the game. She's got three fouls. Struggled a little bit in those minutes. And this puts Tarazi back on the free throw line. First one is good. What was it? Nigeria got it back to 11 yesterday. And their coach usually picked up a technical.
The end of the third quarter, yep.
And that's when the floodgates opened. But in all honesty, Belgium have, this game has been played at a higher level tonight. At least offensively.
Yes. Especially by the U.S., actually.
Messerman catches it. And Belgium finding it difficult to score now. Tarazi wide open for three. And the ball bounced over the backboard. Super checks back in. Inside the final 3 minutes here of the third quarter. Carpio bound behind the back pass. Oh, and Waters. That was going to be a highlight reel play. You got to make that in. Look at Carpio. Behind the back pass is her specialty.
It is her specialty. It's her go-to. And I'm sure she just wanted an opportunity in this game to do that. But you're right. Ann Waters needs to make that layup, and she knew it too.
And how often you have a chance for a three-point play, and then you end up missing a free throw as well. 37 years old, former WNBA star herself. Stewart wide open. And Lloyd challenged Van Loo. Van Loo complaining to Rosso that Jewel Lloyd came over the back. Watch this. Well, she got some ball, but she definitely crashed into Van Loo. Stewart. Good hands. Lloyd from the left. Oh, hits it over Messerman. And the USA now leading it by 10 points. Look at this. Messerman gets her hands up. But Lloyd, we know she can shoot it.
And, you know, this is what I expected from this U.S. team. I thought that they would come out, sort of settle down, start to hit some shots, and that's exactly what we've seen. Diana Taurasi's
hit a couple threes. We saw Brianna Stewart step out, hit some threes. Jewel Lloyd's joining in on the party.
See the points of the paint.
Points of the paint. They're 9 of 20 from three, 45%. They're also 12 of 12 from the free throw line. So they've just elevated and picked up their game. And we kind of always expected this from them. We haven't seen it yet in this tournament. Honestly, until this quarter, I think this is the best quarter of basketball so far the U.S. have played. But we knew this was going to happen. The U.S. were just going to get better and better and better. And they're so talented that they can elevate their game to whoever they're playing against. And that's what we're seeing tonight. This Belgium team have played great.
Yeah, they've had moments where both teams have made some mistakes, but I don't think Belgium, you can have any complaints the way they've come after things tonight. Now, I'm not saying that there was a foul on Jewel Lloyd, but if that foul is not called, they don't get possession, and she doesn't get the three-pointer. So that is the, it's a seven-point game.
You and I talked. Maybe it was a foul. Maybe it was kind of an over-the-back foul, but we keep on saying this time and time again, time and time again in every game. For the most part, I really do believe that the refereeing evens out. Yeah. Call goes against you, call goes for you.
And now Bird is having a word with the referee, so poor referees can never win, can they? All they do is their best. Van Loo makes two free throws. It's back to eight. Now Brant Griner gets it. And she was fouled before the shot by Waters. So free throws for Griner. That's her first. Bring it up on the personality. And really, the only way you can stop this, I mean, Linskins did a pretty good job in the first half with that deny. But if she gets position on you, you're toast.
We did see that double the one time in the first half by Mestag when the ball did get in.
Yeah.
But like you said, if you let her catch it low, I mean, she's going to score 80% of the time.
Yeah, she's going to score 80% of the time, 90% of the time. Wait, here we go. There was a joke in there somewhere. Mestag. Van Loo going right at Bird. Lloyd grabs it, brings it back. Now Deladon. Griner again posting up. Now Stewart and 2 points scores over Messaman.
With the contact. I mean, that just kind of shows you how talented Stewart is, too. That was a tough basket for her to make.
And now Deladon saw the pass coming. She gets in transition over to Lloyd. Over to Stewart, and the USA have taken a 69-55 lead here in the final minute of the third quarter. Oh, Carprio, how in the world? A little runner off the backboard.
I thought for a second it might be one of her passes.
Yeah. She's a fun and interesting player to watch. And it goes Stewart and USA getting some joy now down low. Again, maybe one behind the back pass too many. And I think the foul on Van Loo.
And they're going to be shooting. Probably not the smartest foul.
That was the shot that she made.
Did it not look like she was possibly looking for Ann Waters on that?
Yeah, I mean, maybe it was a pass come shot, is that what they call it? Turned into a shot. We take some time, and what are the USA at the free throw line right now?
14 to 14.
15 to 15 right, now. 16 of 16. And the long attempt from Messelman. Well, you know what? USA are, without a doubt, talented, and they are the defending champions, and now they lead it by 16 over Belgium.
And here we have the stats after three quarters. It's still a great basketball game. You have Belgium shooting 52%, but look at the free throws, 16 to 16 for the US. Belgium have been made nine out of 11, which is also a great free throw percentage. And I said, I'm disappointed with the way people have been shooting the free throw. The US for this tournament have been shooting 80%. So they are one of the teams who, you know, I think are shooting at the level that you need to be shooting your free throws at. You just get a sense in that third quarter with the way that Diana Taurasi came out, hit a couple of those early threes. Mestag also went back down on the other end and hit some big shots herself. But you felt, I don't even want to say it was a momentum shift, but the U.S. just sort of settled in and started playing USA basketball. They started hitting open shots. I also thought their pace, they had picked it up. You know, I saw there a few times Sue Bird was telling them, like, hey, come on, we gotta run. And it's true, they had more scoring opportunities, early scoring opportunities, and they were taking advantage of that. You know, they have 17 fast break points compared to just 5 from Belgium. And that's just, this is the pace and the opportunities that I think the U.S. have to look at playing at as this tournament moves on, you know, this last 10 minutes and then tomorrow's game.
Well, for Belgium really to have any hope here, they need to make inroads now, and they've got to get stops. Messelman comes out, misses the jumper. Charles with the rebound. Lloyd for three. And DeMar brings it up for the Belgians. Behind their back again to Messelman. Now Bird. Cross court over to Taurasi. Deladon, good. 75-57. Carpio again behind the back to Mestag this time. Hits the three. Gets it back to 15. Points the deficit. You know, if USA miss, the Belgians have to limit their opportunities. They get the block there, but nobody was there to pick up the ball. DeLar for three. Good. Belgium starting to heat up again. Back to 14 points. Charles, fade away. Boy, I'll tell you what.
Unstoppable, that shot. I'm not sure what more Mesman could have done guarding that ball.
You just have to applaud Charles and the USA. I mean, they're playing very well offensively. And now Mesman gets tangled up with Deladon and goes down. Deladon helps her up. And she caught a blow to the face.
Might have been by Tarazi, actually. Look at this. Tell me what more could you possibly have done to make Charles shoot a more difficult shot? And she still made it, like, without hesitation.
Messman goes inside, scores with a reverse. But you really, you know, no matter the end result here, you just have to appreciate this game. It's a real celebration of basketball. Both these teams playing at a high level. And obviously the USA at a high, the highest level.
I mean,
Tarazi. And again, Carpio commits the foul, but does not prevent the made basket.
I expected the U.S. to come out and play at a higher level than they have been playing at. You know, this is do or die. This is to get to the finals, the gold medal match. And I don't think I should be surprised anymore by how good this Belgium team is. But I just, they still keep taking my breath away.
Yeah, they've competed against the USA team that's playing well. That hasn't missed a free throw tonight. They're 17 of 17. Carpio pulls up. Nobody under the boards. Alemán's going to come back in. A rare turnover for the USA. Now Delar. USA get back on defense, though. Bounce pass, beautiful play! But Messman can't finish. And the Charles down low. And Charles now is having her way. So many weapons for the USA. Oh, beautiful play, Belgium. Messman was patient. Mestag was patient. And it finished with a Carpio layup. Bird from the left. Good! Finally gets one to go. Sue Bird. 20 points, the lead for the USA. And a foul was called. They count the basket and also an off the ball foul, which will keep the ball in Belgium's hands. This was Bird's three-pointer on the previous
and
possession for the USA.
I wonder here, you know, you saw Coach Mestag of Belgium took out Messman, took out Delar.
Quick pass into Lenskins from Nalas, and that's a four-point trip down the floor.
I'm wondering if he's thinking, okay, I don't want to say time is running out. There's still 5.5 minutes left, but you're down 14. When do you start thinking about tomorrow?
Offensive foul on Tarazi. Yes, well, that ref thought that was a foul. Now Lenskins gets a chance against Charles. Oh, she had a handful of shirt and she still made it. Charles lucky to get away with one there.
Lenskins, a 21-year-old with no fear.
Rahman guarding Stewart, grabs the board. It's a 14-point deficit. Belgium
Oh, beautiful bounce pass. Rahman just didn't finish. Quickly to Stewart. And Mestag fouls her. Say Rahman plays hard. You can't falter. Just doesn't have quite that same touch in some of her drives to the basket. Van Loo comes in for Mestag. And here's Linskins again. Look at her tugging on her shirt. But she still made it. Linskins has done herself, you know, she's raised eyebrows tonight.
Oh.
Stewart makes the first one.
And there's definitely some WNBA scouts, GMs watching this game.
Thinking, I'll have some of that.
She's 21 years old. And she has not backed down at all. I thought she's had a great tournament for them. You know, she was starting in the place of Ann Waters, who started for them last summer at the Eurobasket, where they, as we talked about her, she then gets an offensive foul.
But that's right.
You know, she's starting. This is the first time she's really starting for this Belgium team. And has she ever held her own? Yeah, I mean.
Yeah, she slid it to her too late.
Have her feet set.
Boom. Oh, gosh. Good call by the ref. Johnny on the spot. Linskins now. Linskins has four fouls. Oh, Griner catches down low. Good help, D. Griner gets it back and puts it up and in. She is a tower of power. Seems like she has more than that. 16 points.
And Brittany Griner has also been battling an injury for this USA team, and we haven't really seen her perform at her ability until today either. It's kind of scary when you think about it, and how they will possibly be playing tomorrow.
Tarazi, another three. Alamon. Big pass to Rahman.
And that's her 12th assist. Do you think she might break her own World Cup record?
She could do it.
We mentioned yesterday she had 13 assists, which is tied for a World Cup record.
And of course, USA, when they scored their first point today, that gave them 10,000 points. Linskins. And Tarazi saves it in bounds. And Rahman comes in. And this is another layup. And now Griner posting up and has contact with Rahman. So Rahman goes down, and the offensive foul. Applause for the USA players as they come out of the game. Leslie Clarendon comes in, Morgan Tuck comes in, Lloyd comes out. Nika Gulmake is in. Asia Jones. Kelsey Plum. Here's Alamon and the three-pointer short. Alamon for three. So it's been a great basketball game, one that was close, really. What would you say, until midway through the third quarter, when the USA really started to turn it on? And really, both countries should be proud. The USA starting to shift into that higher gear, and of course Belgium coming out and not backing down against the champions, basically. The defending champions. Their own championship aspirations taking a hit tonight.
They'll still play for third. Plum for three. Now Alemán has it. Van Loo. Now Lauer's short. And Rahman put it up thinking, I think, that the shot clock had not reset. Well, I suppose in a way, as the game draws to an end here, the final minute 11, sort slightly anticlimactic, but I feel just so good about the health of certainly the women's game, having watched these two teams trade blows. I know the USA welcomed the challenge tonight. And Belgium are only going to get better. Leija Clarendon.
Yeah, like you said, Jeff, this Belgium team, they're...
Alemán goes right down the lane for the layup.
They have an average age of 26. I mean, you just saw Alemán, 22. We saw Linskins battle against the bigs of the U.S. She's only 21 years old. Messman's only 25, people. I mean, Kim Mestag, a veteran, she's still only 28. I really think for a few years, we're going to see a Belgium team that's maybe going to continue to compete at the highest level on the world stage.
And how many other young Belgians are being inspired by these Belgian cats who have come out and given us a night to remember with the USA. Both teams have been terrific. And Van Loo puts it up from the corner, and that is it. Well played, both teams. The USA march into the final, where they will take on the winner of Spain, Australia, who play next. Belgium, they will play in the third place game against the loser of that next semifinal. Wonderful game, ultimately won by the USA, 93-77. Beautiful scenes here in the Santiago Martín. I mean, clearly Belgium really looked forward to this night. They gave a great account of themselves. And the USA, well, they had a, you know, they had a game tonight. And they also enjoyed this wonderful atmosphere. And Messemann and Griner, they know each other from Europe, from the WNBA. And that's the way the game is now. And that's one of the beauties of the women's game, is you have a lot of players on both sides of the Atlantic. They play a lot of games. But anyway, the full-time stats, I mean, 19 of 19 for the USA from the line and 10 of 25 from deep. Yeah, they just did not make mistakes.
They really didn't. But look at that. Belgium still had 25 assists. They shot 52% against a very talented and strong defensive team that is the USA. I mean, there's a reason why the US are the best in the world. They're good on defense and they're great on offense. Here we have Messman with 23 points. Star of the game is Tarazi, though. After yesterday's game, which was really frustrating for her, you saw, I mean, at the beginning of the game and in warm-ups, I saw a different look on Diana Taurasi's face. In her eyes, she was all business today, Jeff.
Dawn Staley, you know, her team, Messman, the big numbers. I mean, for Belgium, you know, you are literally, you're not just taking on the best. You're taking on the best of all time. I mean, you're taking on Diana Taurasi. And Diana Taurasi saved her greatest game for Belgium tonight in this tournament. And you couple that with Griner, with Della Dawn, with Tina Charles coming up big in the end, with Jewel Lloyd. I mean, this was an immense performance by Belgium.
Brianna Stewart still had 20 points?
Yeah, I mean, this is just an awesome effort from Belgium, and you also have to applaud the USA. They just keep moving from strength to strength.
So here are the highlights. We had plenty from both teams.
You see Mestag. I mean, another great performance by Mestag as well. She finished with 12 points. She was the star of the team yesterday that, along with Messman, got them here. I thought she came out and hit some big shots, 5-for-10 from the field, 2-for-3 from three. She just didn't force anything and played her game. And, you know, they only lost by 16. And really, the game was a lot closer than that for the majority of the time. So it's just exciting to see where this Belgium team are going to be in the future.
And I'm not splitting hairs here, but just remember that point where Van Loo is trying to get the defensive rebound, and Lloyd comes and keeps it alive, out of bounds. Van Loo wants the foul. It's not given. Possession, USA, Lloyd in the corner hits the three. And that just kind of like helps him pull away even more and more. And it's just a relentlessness by the USA. You know, you have to play near perfect basketball just to have a chance against them.
Yeah, you really do. And that's the only way you're going to beat the U.S. is if you do play a 40-minute game perfectly. And honestly, this Belgium team played a near-perfect game. I think the U.S., they were more talented. They had a little bit deeper bench. There's a reason why they're the number one team in the world.
Yeah, and you know what? You have to look forward to that challenge. You have to take them on. And they did. So they couldn't have done any more tonight than they did. So it's been a great night of basketball already in the semifinal between the United States and Belgium. The United States prevailing to go back into the title game. And now they will face the winner of Spain and Australia.
Diana Taurasi, de los Estados Unidos.
So it's been a great occasion for basketball. You see today already France winning over Nigeria, China winning over Canada. Those are in the classification games. Now USA win over Belgium, and they will face the winner of the second semifinal between Spain and Australia. And the TCL player of the game, Diana Taurasi.